the lovely and talented John Kranz dancing with Paula Ayakano. And then for those of you who are here tonight, who might not know, John is Lauren's grandfather. So one more round of applause. John's going to join me on stage for one quick second. What an amazing performance, my goodness. How do you feel? John, how are you? So give your beautiful granddaughter.
For you. And you too, you're my, the reason I did it. You're my inspiration.
John, I understand you're not a ballroom dancer until very recently.
Yes. And I'll explain that in a little bit.
Okay.
Thanks, Paula, for all of her encouragement and her patience.
I'm sure she needed a lot.
I'd like to thank all of you for being so kind. I'd like to share with you why I did that. But first, I'd like to say something to the Cerebral Palsy families and to everyone with Cerebral Palsy. Art Wallier and I, where's Art?
Right there.
Art Wallier and I have been blessed to have two kind, caring families. And all of us, along with Lauren's amazing volunteers, are dedicated to bringing the symptom recovery model therapy to Western New York, so those of you with cerebral palsy can have an opportunity for a more normal life. In March, in Michigan, Lauren had just an unbelievable evening. It was really exciting. And I was probably flying off the floor. And when we got done, after the professionals performed, I said to Lauren, I really love watching this ballroom dancing, and I do. And then I put my foot in my mouth, and I said, if I wasn't so old, I'd take lessons. Lauren looked up at me. I said, Grandpa, you're never too old. The lady that came in third place in the senior division was 80. Be courageous. So I thought about that from the end of March till the middle of August. And then I decided to go see Paula at Ayakano Ballroom Center. And I said to Paula, I told her how old I was, and I said, my memory isn't what it used to be. I had hoped that she would say, we don't have enough time by November 18th. But she said, we can do it. Stuck again. Lauren, I thought I have an idea what you went through to become the champion you are, but I honestly don't have the slightest idea what you went through, because this is one of the hardest things I've ever done. And actually, one time I told Paul, I think I'm going to have to go to George and Company and get a fake leg cast, because I told too many people I was going to be here, and I wanted to come in with my head up. I'll have to say, Lauren goes to Home by Dark. James Casto's Home by Dark donates three or four times a year part of the aid to her foundation. And Lauren Mayo was there one time, and Lauren introduced Mayo to the audience and said that Mayo was going to make her into something the world has never seen. And as you just saw, he did. Well, Paula is making me into something I never, ever thought I'd ever be. So now I guess I can proudly say I'm one of Lauren's never evers.
How about one more round for John and Paula.